Assalamu alaikum, my name is Abdal and this video is about to explain the fabrication process of two-piece prosthesis which was used to obturate an extensive maxillary defect, and both pieces were joined together intraorally with the help of the magnets. The video that you are watching right now was taken while explaining the insertion and removal method to the patient. Now, talking about the history of the patient, this 63 years old patient was referred to us for this prosthesis by the consultant oral maxillofacial surgeon, who is such a gentleman and competent fellow. This patient had the history of oral mucosis and had undergone the surgical procedure, which is hemimaxillectomy, which was done a couple of months back. After the resection, there was a scar. So we were left with the limited mouth opening, like 16-17 millimeters, safe to say. So in such limited opening, we were not even able to insert comfortably the stock impression tray. So in this situation, it was impossible to insert an obturator, which may also have a huge bulb, which was bulb is that part which is going to cover the defect area. So in this situation, we were left with the most obvious choice: let's make a two-piece prosthesis and join both parts intraorally. Since this video is about the lab prospect, let's jump to the fabrication process. I have the photographs of all the steps and we will discuss the procedure accordingly. As we had discussed earlier, that we were not able to take impression using the conventional impression technique. We not just only had to modify the impression tray, as well as we had to modify our impression technique. So we decided to take the impression using the sectional impression, meaning that we need to take the impression into two steps like that. These are the first models in this technique. We had recorded this part first, the dentate part first, which was the patient right part, right side of the arch, which had the dentate part. So this, by using this technique, we had taken the impression, primary impression, and we had recorded this part properly, while this defect part, the part where we were needed to obturate. So we had to take an other modified impression tray, so that this part to be recorded too. So for that purpose, we had made a special tray, modified trays, whatever you are going to call it, which were able to record this part. And let me show you that picture too. This is again the other part, other photograph. So this is the thing. We had fabricated an impression tray using the cold cure resin self cure, and this was extended up to this extent, and using the low fusing impression compound, which is known as the green streak in our region, tissue molding was done and impression was taken. It was recorded, the defect part was recorded by using this part, and then we joined that impression tray on this part, and after that both parts were poured and we had the final model. Let me show you that. We had marked this area and it was needed to cut into two halves like that. And we have attached this impression to this area like that. we have sealed that impression tray, stock impression, sorry, custom impression tray, special tray with that patch. And after that, we have did the boxing. See, this is the another view of that impression, and we did the boxing of that impression. And after that, we have poured it. These were some guiding locking holes grooves, so that both part to be joined together properly. And here is the final model. If you see that, this was the old model and this one was the new model of that defect area. So both parts were joined together. This is known as the sectional impression technique or sectional model. So by using that, we had the final impression. And after that, we started doing fabrication of action. So this was the design that we first thought. It was modified a little bit. In this design, we decided to make this hard palate part, the first part, and the second part, which was the bulb part, it will be seated afterwards. This design was changed a little bit later, but okay, let's stick to this plan first. This is another picture. Let me go back first. We had made the clasps for that plate too. So we wanted to have a proper retaining prosthesis, which may be retained thoroughly, properly during our fabrication process, like jawlation or trial step. So this was the first part that we have fabricated, the first tray, and we had attached the magnet at this area. And here's another look. So we decided to make another part like that. And here is, if you may able to see it, we have created a channel or groove so that second part may seat here properly. And this channel will guide its to its position. But after fabrication, these were again some guiding holes, but it was changed a bit. I will show you in the next photograph. So when we have fabricated, we have changed the design, and we decided that the defect part, the bulb part, should be seated first, and after that, this hard palate part, this retaining part, should be seated next. This will give more retention, and in theory, we expected that in this way we will get more retention if we change our design a bit. So at this step, we have decided to change it a bit, and here we are. This is the first part. Now we have changed it. This was the first part. It is going to be seated first, and this is the guiding groove which will guide the other half to seat at its position, and magnet will attract the remaining second half of the prosthesis. Here it is, first half, second half, and this is how it will look while joined together. After that, we have fabricated the back seams to have the idea about the vertical relationship. This is another view, this is another view, and here we are. We had taken the jawlation, and when the jawlation came to the lab, we have articulated over the articulator and did the setup accordingly. If you have observed in this situation, we had not done the spot grinding first, and in theory we have decided that it should be done at the time of insertion, because we were feeling that the patient may have not 100% exact this relation, but hopefully we were hoping that impression material impression relation jaw relation should be same, your occlusion relation should be same. So this is the labial view, this is the palatal view of the tooth setup. Trial had been done, and this is the final wax up position after the trial. We have done the final wax up like that. First part, second part, guiding groove, and these are the magnets. So this whole plate was changed afterwards. These plates are fabricated in the self-cure while the final plate was transferred into the heat cure. Final wax up before flasking, and this is the final processed appliance after the fabrication, after the curing process of the acrylic. If you see in this picture, this area has been marked because we decided to make a hollow shape at this area to reduce the weight of the obturator, this obturator part, or what you can call it, bulbar defect part. This was the magnet that we applied in our final prosthesis. It is big in bit big in the size, and the science and hope was that it will have strong force, strong pull, so it will keep the prosthesis into its place. This is another view, and this is the final prosthesis after the polishing. We had made a couple of duplicate models. This part was flasked in one, processed in one flask. This other half was processed in other, on other model in other flask. So we had a couple of duplicate models to process this whole, whole processes. And if you see it closely, here is the hole that was created. Bit of amount of acrylic was removed to reduce the weight of the prosthesis. So this is the final prosthesis. This is it looked like. This is the insertion process. Bit of what you call it, spot grinding was done later on, and this is how it looked like. This is the frontal view, and we had the limited mouth opening. So this way we have fabricated two piece prostheses. So here's the question, why we have used the magnet for this process? Thing is that although we have different options like implants, like precision attachments, first those are a bit expensive, and in our region we can't charge patient a hefty amount. So we need some economical ways to process it, to produce, to fabricate such devices. And another thing that magnet has benefit over other options. First one is the those magnets are economical, and secondly, you don't have to be very much precise to place that model. The magnetic force will pull and place the other half to its position. You don't have to be very much precise to place both parts. So we have inserted this prosthesis to the patient like 3 weeks ago, I think. Patient is used to it now, and he is quite confident and bit satisfied. I'm not gonna say use the word happy, but he is quite satisfied right now. So this was the case report, case procedure that we have performed. I hope that it will help others to give another prospect, the other way of fabricating and looking into device. This is the most economical way. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the comment section. And one thing more, we have fabricated a case and other case like that that has been published in a foreign journal. I'm gonna give that link of that case report, that publication too, and I will give the link of that.